So now let's solve a differential equation using the Laplace transform technique. The differential equation is going to be x double dot plus x equals sine 2t with two initial conditions, x of 0 equals 2 and x dot of 0 equals 1. We know how to solve this inhomogeneous differential equation already by a method of ansatz. But here I want to solve it using this Laplace transform technique and show you that you can get the same solution. So we take the Laplace transform of this differential equation. So we get the Laplace transform of x double dot plus the Laplace transform of x equals the Laplace transform of sine 2t. We don't have to do any work. We don't have to do any integrals. What we need to do is to look at the table and read these Laplace transforms off of the table. So let's have a look at the table now. So to Laplace transform the second derivative of x, we use line 16. So that will be equal to s squared times capital X minus s of the initial value of x, which is 2, so minus 2s minus x dot of 0, which is 1. And then to Laplace transform sine 2t, we use line 6, which will be b is equal to 2, so it will be 2s squared plus 2 squared, which is 4. So making use of the table then, we can go ahead and do the transform. So we have s squared capital X minus 2s minus 1 plus, there is no first derivative in this equation. In a general equation, you would have a first derivative, but here there is none. So plus x is equal to the Laplace transform of sine 2t, which from the table is 2 over s squared plus 4. Okay, we need to solve for x. So we have s squared plus 1 times x equals the right-hand side, which is going to be 2s plus 1 plus 2 over s squared plus 4. And finally, we get our capital X, which will be 2s plus 1 over s squared plus 1 plus 2 over s squared plus 1 times s squared plus 1. Okay, so we've transformed the equation and then solved the algebraic equation. So now we have the solution for x in S space, okay, making use of the initial conditions. The remaining step in this solution procedure then is to take the inverse Laplace transform of this solution to get x of t. Okay, this is the most difficult step. Let's look at the table now and see what exactly we need to transform these two terms. The first term is a 2s plus 1 over s squared plus 1. The second term is a 2 divided by s squared plus 1 times s squared plus 4. So let's look at the table. Okay. To transform the 2s plus 1 over s squared plus 1 term, we're going to make use of line 7 and line 6. So here b is equal to 1, and we're going to have a 2 times s over s squared plus 1, which will be using line 7, And we're going to have 1 over s squared plus 1, which will be using line 6. Then to transform the 2 over s squared plus 1 times s squared plus 4 term, we're going to have to use a partial fraction decomposition to write that in terms of something divided by s squared plus 1 plus something divided by s squared plus 4. Let me show you that partial fraction decomposition now. So to do the partial fraction decomposition, we need to write 2 over s squared plus 1 times s squared plus 4 as something over s squared plus 1. That something will be an unknown coefficient a times s plus b plus something over s squared plus 4, which will be an unknown coefficient c times s plus d. And this is the standard form for a partial fraction decomposition. To determine the coefficients a, b, c, and d, you can either stare at it really hard, or you can do some algebra. It's a little bit easier to just do some algebra, not so it doesn't hurt your brain so much. You multiply this side by top and bottom by s squared plus 4. So putting under this denominator on the left, you multiply the second term top and bottom by s squared plus 1. And then you set the s cubed, s squared, and s term to 0, and set the constant term to 2. And when you do that, you can get a solution that you find a equals c equals 0, b is equal to 2/3, and d is equal to minus 2/3. Okay. Putting everything together now, we have our x is going to be, we're going to have to write that as 2 times s over s squared plus 1 plus 1 over s squared plus 1. And then we have this extra term. So we have a is 0, b equals 2/3, and so we have a 2/3 plus 2/3 over 1 over s squared plus 1. And d is minus 2/3. So because of we need, if we have an s squared plus 4 in the denominator, we'll see from the table that we need a 2 in the numerator. So I will write that as minus 1/3 times 2 over s squared plus 4. Okay? This 1 over s squared plus 1 term will combine. So 1 of them plus 2/3 of them will give us 5/3 of them. So we'll end up with 3 pieces here. And then we'll be able to write down our solution for x of t after we consult the table. You still need the table to do the inverse Laplace transform. So let's have a second look at the table now. Okay, so we're trying to transform the term s over s squared plus 1. That will come from line 7. B equals 1, so that will be a cosine t. And then transform the term 1 over s squared plus 1. That will be from line 6. That will be a sine t. And finally, transform the term 2 over s squared plus 4. That will come from also from line 6, but b will be equal to 2. Okay, so now using the table to do this transform, we get the first term is going to be 2 times cosine t. The second term, that's from here, the second term will come from plus 5/3 sine t. And then this last term here will be minus 1/3 times a sine 2t. Okay, so all of this from the table of the taking the inverse Laplace transform using the table of the Laplace transform. Okay, let me review then what I've done here. We have an initial value problem, one that we already know how to solve using the method of ansatz. But here I'm showing you how to solve this by the Laplace transform method. We take the Laplace transform of the differential equation, and then using the table. And after doing that, then we can solve for x in S space. The complicated procedure is that we have to then take the inverse Laplace transform of this to get back x of t. The first term we can figure out from the table. The second term is not in the table. So what we need to do is a partial fraction decomposition. That requires a bit of algebra. But you can, if you remember your partial fraction decomposition, you know how to write this expression. And then the algebra will tell you what these coefficients are. Then we have our x of s with these four terms. Two of the terms combine, so we actually have three terms. And they're all written in a way that we can read the inverse transform off of the table. When we look at the table and read the inverse transform, then we get our solution here. X of t is 2 cosine t plus 5/3 sine t minus 1/3 sine 2t. From our previous knowledge of solving differential equations, you'll recognize the first two terms are the homogeneous solution, and the last term is the particular solution. And the coefficients of the homogeneous solution are chosen so that you satisfy the two initial conditions. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.